stating the goal. Typically, the goal of the analysis will be stated in terms of solving a problem or answering a question. When stating the goal of the analysis, you should try to be as specific as possible. The more specific you are, the easier it will be to develop and outline your criteria. Following are some examples of problems with a geospatial component. Where is the best place to install nest boxes for barn owls? How often does the bathymetry of the Eureka Slough change over time? What factors influence crime in McKinleyville? What places in our state and national parks are most affected by illegal marijuana grows? While these questions are a good place to start, it would be more useful to state the goals and objectives in a way that includes specific details. Let's take our barn owl nest box problem. Rodents such as gophers and voles can cause significant damage to vineyards as they chew on roots and bark. In Napa Valley, California, some farmers are turning to barn owls as an environmentally friendly means to control the rodent population. In order to attract barn owls, farmers will install empty nest boxes around their vineyards, but the question is where to install them. If we state the problem in a general way, we might come up with something like this. The objective of this analysis is to determine the best location for installing barn owl nest boxes. This is a good starting point, but framing the problem or objective in a more specific way will help to determine what our criteria will be and what data we might need to acquire. Instead, you might use the following wording. The objective of this analysis is to determine the environmental factors influencing barn owl selection of nest boxes, including land cover, vegetation types, hydrology, and proximity to urban features such as roads. By framing the problem with a detailed statement, begin to solidify what your model might look like and what information you will need to build it.